So what we have to do is, in this question, we have to find the third largest element in an array. So let's say there is an array given to you. Let's take an array. So let's say an array is something like this. 5, 10, 2, 3, 8, 4. Okay. So the answer in this case would be what? The answer in this case would be 2, 3, 4. The third largest element, right? So 10, 8, and 5. So answer would be 5 in this case. Let's take another example. So there is an array given to you where the array is like this. Okay, so you have to tell me the third largest element in this case as well. So what will be the third largest element in this case? Let's take a couple of more elements. Okay, so let's say the answer, because you have 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 4, 5, 7, 5, 4. So the third largest element is 4. So how do we find the third largest element in such cases? Yes. So what we need to do here is that we need to find the third largest element. Now, how do you approach this particular problem? Anyone?
Logically, what we'll do is we'll order the array in a descending descending manner, and from the third index would be the
correct. Exactly. Will it be a third index? Are you sure about that?
No, n minus 3, not the third.
Okay, so you're arranging it in a descending order or ascending order?
Ascending order. If it's ascending orders, then it will be n minus 3.
Okay, and if it's, let's say if you arrange it in descending order, then?
It will be second, 0, 1, 2, second.
Are you sure about that?
No, because there is again chances that it will be repeated multiple times.
Exactly. Correct. So there are multiple things which we need to consider here. So in general, I'll give you a tip. So before you start with a solution, interviewer might will give you just one or two examples on which you have to solve this particular problem. Correct. They might not consider all the corner cases. Correct. So given the first example, you will think that the solution would be what? I'll just sort it in the descending order, and then what we'll do, once I've sorted it in descending order, then I just need to figure out the first 0, 1, 2, so second index will be the element. But as soon as I came up with this example, your solution won't work. So what you should try to do is you should try to come up with all the edge cases, the corner cases. Make sure that you understand the question very properly. Okay. So always pay attention on the question which is given to you and try to take all the possible cases. So as mentioned, we can't directly, take the third index. So one approach is, let's call it as a brute force approach, where what we are doing is we are sorting the elements in the descending order. So what are we doing? Sorting the elements in the descending order. Correct? Descending order. Correct. Once the elements are sorted in the descending order, then what do we need to do? Once you sort the elements in descending order, then we need to find the element which is third largest. Correct. Now, how to do that? So what you can do is you can find the unique elements which are present. So what you will do is you need to find the third unique element present from the beginning in the array. Now see here, sorting, we'll run the sorting algorithms, and once we'll go on to the sorting algorithms, we'll try to see how exactly the sorting works. But for now, what you can assume is that the elements are, once you actually, once you get the array, and if you sort it, that is in the descending order. The time complexity, we'll talk about the time complexity as well. The time complexity to actually sort all the elements is n log n. Okay. the time complexity, again, this will be discussed as a part of the sorting algorithms. Well, we'll come on to the sorting algorithms soon. So it will be discussed as a part of the sorting algorithms. So for now, you are assume that this array, you have sorted with the help of the sorting algorithm. Now, after that, what you need to do is you need to find the element which is third largest in the array. How you will do that? So see, let's say if we sort the first one, then what are you getting? You're getting what? You'll get 10, 8, 5, 4, 3, and 2. Correct? Now, what you do is every time, whenever there is a new element which is appearing. So let's say if you compare ARRI and ARRI minus 1. Correct? So how to find the third unique elements? So what you do is you maintain account to find unique elements. Correct? Elements appear. Or to count, maintain the account to find the unique, to count the unique elements appear. Okay, so let's say the number of elements appeared so far was 1. And how do you maintain a count? How do you count it? So for that, what do you need to do? You need to start a for loop from the beginning. And what do? You, whenever ARR of I is not equal to ARR of I plus 1, correct? Then what do? You, or let's say we start a loop from I plus, start a for loop from the beginning plus 1 index, correct? And what do you see? Whenever ARR of I is not equal to ARR of I minus 1. That means that this element is not equal to this element, correct? That means that we got a unique element. So what do? You increment the count. You keep on incrementing the count, and as soon as you get a third count, that will be the third. As soon as, what do you do it after that? So as soon as you get a third count, return the answer. Correct. Now let's try to put this in a code for this particular example. Okay, let's see. So what we are doing is, what we'll do, let's assume that we have sorted the element. So for that, we'll write a sort function, let's say, and we'll keep it empty for now. So what we need to do is we need to find the third largest element. So we need to return integer, correct? And then we need to find third largest, correct? And what are we getting here? We are getting int ARR, correct? You can consider it as array list as well if you want, but let's take, we are getting int ARR. Now what do? We say that sort these elements, sort ARR, sort array, correct? We'll implement this function later on. So let's say this will give us a sorted array. So our array is sorted now. Then after that, what do we need to do? We need to write a for loop. So we need to initialize the count. So int unique ELE count is equal to 0, correct? And then what I do is, or let's say we initialize it to 1, because our first element is, let's say we are always counting ARR 0, correct? And then what do? We say that if ARR of I double equals, so for int I is equal to 0, sorry, for int I is equal to 0, I is less than n I plus plus, correct? Let's say you have got the size of the array. Okay. Now, what do? After that is, you say for int I is equal to 0, for int i is equal to 1, I is less than n, I plus plus. And what do you say? If ARR of I is not equal to ARR of I minus 1, correct? That means that the element which is appearing is a unique element now, correct? So what we do, you simply write unique count, unique ALE count plus plus, correct? Correct. So we have incremented the value here. Now after that, what do we need to do? If this is done, can we also check if the unique count is equal to 3? So can I say that if at any point in time, unique element count, point of time, unique element count equal to 3, then we simply need to return the answer. So what will return? Here in this case, we'll say return whatever is the answer, which is equal to, so which is, here we have incremented the value. So that means that this is the element which is the third unique element. So we'll return error. Now see, because this complex, let's try to figure out the complexity of this function. So this is what, order of n log n. Why n log n? As I just mentioned that the sorting takes n log n in worst case. So we'll implement a sort which will give you all order of n log n complexity. We'll discuss about the sorting algorithm as well as its complexity at a later point of time. For this one, see, we are just writing a for loop. So we are accessing all the elements once and there are n elements. So for this for loop, the worst case complexity will be what? Order of n. Now there is one thing which you need to notice. So let's say if you don't get unique element count equal to 3 till the end, then what we need to return? We return minus 1 in that case, which says that these elements are like, or we can throw an exception as well, because there is no third largest element. If it is given to you that always the element will be present, then you don't need to worry about this. This will automatically work. Or you can say return some int min or some, or you can simply throw an exception from it. Throw an assertion at it. Throw new assertion error. Why assertion error? Assertion error is thrown when it is unexpected that your code will actually come onto this line. So if it is mentioned that always the third largest element will be present, then ideally you should be able to return your answer from here. So it should not never ever come here. So you in such cases you throw an assertion error. Element not. So you can return this. Now, what is the overall complexity of this function? So if you talk about the complexity here, it comes out to be what? Order of n log n for sorting plus order of n. Order of n for loop, which you have written later. So overall complexity will become what? Order of n log n. Correct. Don't worry if you didn't understand this complexity. We will discuss this in detail at a later. So this is the brute force algorithm because we are taking order of n log n complexity to sort the elements. Now let's see if our answer will work on the other example as well or not. So this was the second example which we were taking, correct? So let's say if we have this array, then let's see if it is working on this example or not. So what we are doing is now, we will sort the array in the descending order. So what will be the elements after descending order? So 7, 5, there is 1, 7. Correct. Then there are 2 5s. So we'll put both the 5s here. Then there are 1, 2, 2 4s. So we'll put both the 4s here. Then there are 3 3s. So we'll put all the 3s here. Then there are 2 2s. And then there are 2 1s. Correct. So this means that, so this gives you the sorted array in the descending order. Now what we need to do, we again need to check if the third, what is the third largest element. So what are we doing? First we are sorting. So this is our sorted array. Then what we are doing, we are initializing our unique element count equal to 1. That means that we are assuming that this element is always unique. Okay. Let's say we have one more 7. I'll explain you why we are doing that. Let's say we have one more 7. So we don't, let's say it will become 7, 7. Okay. 7, 7. Correct. So right now we are standing here and we are saying that consider this is a unique element. Okay. So we did that. Now we are starting our for loop from I equal to 1. I is less than n, I plus plus. So our I is equal on this, we are standing on this index, I is equal to 1. And then we are checking if ARR of I is equal to, is not equal to ARR of I minus 1. So this and this are equal. So we won't do anything. Our unique count is still, will still remain 1. So again, we will increment the I. So I will come here. Now, what are we checking? We are again checking if error of I is not equal to error of I minus 1. I minus 1. So here, I and I minus 1 are not equal. So we are incrementing the unique count. The unique count became what? Unique count will be 2. So this is the second element which is different. Correct? So we will count that element. Again, we are checking if it is equal to 3. It is not equal to 3 yet because till here the count is equal to 2. Then again, we are incrementing. So you are coming out of this 5. This 5 and this 5 are equal. So nothing will happen here. We'll again increment. We'll do I plus plus. We'll come here. Now, error of I is equal to error of I is not equal to error of I minus 1. Yes, that is true. So what we'll do? We'll increment the unique count, unique element count. That becomes 3. If the unique element count is equal to 3, then what are we doing? We are returning the answer from here, which is equal to index. So what are error of I? What is error of I? Error of I is equal to 4. So we'll return 4 in this case. Okay. So this will give, this will handle our cases where we are getting the repeated elements as well. Do you think that this particular solution will also handle the negative elements? Any one of you? You think that this will also take care of negative elements? The elements with a negative value will also be taken care with the solution which we have just proposed?
Yes, it will take care.
It will take care, right? So basically what it will do is it will automatically sort the elements in that form. If all the numbers are negative, that will also be automatically taken care. Okay? So you should try to write the solution which works in general for all the possible test cases or edge cases, and you should come up with all these edge cases before you start writing the solution. Now, let's say I'm saying that if we can further optimize this particular solution. So right now the complexity which we are getting is order of n log n. Now, if I tell you that you can do it with the help of just a for loop in order of n complexity, then can you people think of a solution with the order of n? So let's say this is the array given to you and you need to figure out this in order of n. So how we'll solve this problem? Okay, let's try to understand. So let's say if I ask you to find the largest.
Hi.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Can we try the option wherein we typically try to find out the maximum element by keeping an index, and then if it is not greater than the already existing, we generally loop through, right? There is one algorithm where we just loop through the entire, and if that ARR of I is not greater than that max element, find out the maximum element. Like that, we can try to keep three variables.
Exactly. Correct. Yeah, you're correct. Yes, you're correct. That is the right approach. So let's try to understand. So if I ask you that, you're correct. You're very correct. That's how we'll approach this particular problem. So see, if I ask you that find the largest element, then what you would have simply done is you'll run a loop. What you'll do is you will take a, you will assume that this one is the maximum so far. Correct. And then you run a loop from here. And you'll keep on checking if you get an element which is greater than the current element. Then you actually make that. Greater than the max element so far, you actually make that as a max element and you run the for loop, and once the for loop is completed, your max element is stored in your that particular variable which you are maintaining, max element so far, and you return that as an answer. Okay. So now we have to do a similar thing for three elements. So what we'll do is we'll create three elements. Okay. What you do is we'll initialize first. What we'll say is first equal to what? First equal to. So let's write the complete function int. We need to find what? We need to find the third largest element. Third largest element. Correct. And what we have got is int arr. Correct. And int. Okay. Now what we'll do is we'll take three variables. Int first equal to arr 0. Okay, we'll do int second equal to arr of 1, arr of 0 again. Sorry. Okay, and then we'll do int third equal to error of 0. Okay. So we have initialized everything with error of 0. Then what we do is we'll run a for loop. We'll run a for loop for end I is equal to 0. Let's say I is less than n, I plus plus. Correct. Now what we'll do is we'll check. What we'll check? We'll check if error of I is greater than first. If it is greater than first, then what does it mean? That first actually maintains what? The largest element. Second maintains the second largest element, and third maintains the third largest element. So if error of I is greater than first, then what we'll do is we'll say that if that is the case, then simply do what? Simply assign third will become what? Third will be equal to second. Second will become what? Second will be equal to third. Second will be equal to first. Sorry. Second will be equal to first. And your first will become equal to what? The new ARRI which you have. Now it is quite possible that the element which we are getting is not greater than the first element, but it is greater than the second element. Correct? It is not greater than the first element, but it is greater than the second element. So what we'll write here, we'll write else if condition. And what we'll mention? Else if error of I is greater than second, then what do? We simply say make third is equal to second and second equal to the new element which you have, the current element which is equal to error of. Now it is also possible that it is not greater than the first and the second element, but it is greater than the third element. So we'll write else if error of I is greater than third, then do what? Then assign your third to error of I. Okay. And even if it is not greater than third element, then we don't need to update our first, second and third at all. We'll simply increment the pointer. And then what we'll do, once the for loop is completed, then we'll have first, second and third stored as the first three largest element, and we can return the third element. Now, one thing which you need to notice here is that it is quite possible that only two different types of elements are given to you. Let's say you have 111, 22, 22, 1111. In that case, your first, second and third will be initialized to 1. And at some point, your first will become 2, your second will remain 1, and third will also remain 1. Right? But that's a problem. So what we'll check if first double equal to second or second double equals to third. If any of this holds true, then what do we need to do? We need to throw new assertion error. And what do we say? We say that this shouldn't be possible. Element not a third largest element not found. And then after that, what do? If that is not the case, then you simply return what? Return third. Okay. So you return the third element, and that's how you will get the first three largest element, and you will get the third element, and you can return the third element. And what is the time complexity? So here, if you'll see, the time complexity, we have just used a for loop here, and this will be the for loop, so it will be order of n. If we'll talk about the space complexity, then this is the new space which we are using, first, second and third, but this is a constant space. So the space complexity in this question is what? The time complexity is order of n, and the space complexity is what? Space complexity is order of okay